welcome to today's video. Make sure you visit podcastformarketers.com for more information. Over there, I have a really kick-ass course on how you can make at least a few grand a month on simple reoccurring revenue, right? And that's called Freedom Funnels. And make sure that you like this video and subscribe to my channel, man. I'm put out videos every day, so you don't want to miss what I put up, because I put out some pretty kick-ass content. And man, I always want you guys to comment below, man. I love, absolutely love all the comments you guys bring. Let me know what you're thinking. If you have any questions, I'm always in the comment section. I really love the community. Let's get into the video. All right, guys. So I wanted to talk about basic landing pages for a moment. Like, I mean, it's like I kind of like hate to tell you guys how to click buttons, because you know that's not my thing, right? Tell me how to click fucking buttons. But there's some of you guys out there that are a little confused on how this shit even works, even with any page builder, right? And so I wanted to show you the basics. Now, this is a WordPress site. This is Frank Kern's site. But I wanted to show you pretty much how easy it is to put anything together. So obviously I went and got his header, and I got this piece here. And so I kind of wanted to show you how easy it is to put this together. So with Landingi, you get sections, right? And so now I know that, and you have a choice here. You can either make this one section, or you can make it two sections. It's kind of up to you, right? So I want to show you what two sections will look like. You make it a full width page. All right, and we're going to take it up here like this. And we're going to turn it black, because that's what colors his is. And so there you have it. Now, you can decide to take the logo and just stick it right here. Okay. And we'll take my big ass logo and put it there. All right, so now you can take the logo and stick it there. And then you can take your navigation and put your navigation over here. Now, you also have another choice with your navigation on how you want it to stack up. Do you want to put it one piece like this, right? And it's kind of up to you on how you decide to do that, though. So you can put links and little separation pieces here, more links. Even more links, and one more. Okay, so you can kind of do that. Align it center, and that will be your navigation if you want to. You can make the text a bit more longer, larger, whatever. But you get the gist. Now, you can do that this way, because you have to remember that when you add the tablet, it's going to look a certain way, right? And when you take it to mobile, it's going to look a certain way. So you have to remember how you want this to stack up. Now, normally that's what happens when you make two different sections here. They will stack on top of each other. Normally that's what happens, right? So if you want to make sure that you're going to be mobile ready, it's not going to be too much dicking around, then you stack them up. Now you're going to have these type of problems like this. So in mobile, you might want to make this smaller, center it. And then here, maybe you want to make this your text a little bit smaller. So they'll just be regular links. Okay, and maybe we'll just drag this up here. No. Now, this right here is cool, right? Because what it tells you, if you move this, it's going to move in your other viewers, right? So, because you're in a totally different section, right? So, a lot of times what I'll do in this situation is I'll duplicate this, okay? Stick this up here. Take the little... take the head, right? This is the one, and you go to this advanced tab. Now, this is in all three. So you say, you know what? Don't put this one in mobile. I only want this one to show in mobile, right? And so now, everything stays cool, right? But here, actually, you want to take this one out. My bad. You want to take this one out of those two. So everything stays cool. But in mobile, things are a little bit different, right? So remember that you have that little advanced tab over here to kind of change things around for mobile. Again, ClickFunnels does this, but not as well as LandingEye. Okay. Like I said, if you're going to do something, and I like that they have this little where the fold is to let you know exactly where things are going to land, right? So, but let us move on. From now on, I'm just going to start with showing you how this works in the desktop view, right? But you're starting to see, right? Now, we don't want to copy this dude right off the, you know, right off the rip with everything, but you can start to see that, you know, you could, if you wanted to, knock old Frank off, and it looks pretty damn good in the iPad, okay? So all you would do at this point now, you would have to make your decision on whether or not you wanted two sections to go here or not. So what I did with this and how I did this is I put down a section and then I just went to the background, okay? And I put an image in the background of that, right? So now, if you want to put content here, this will just remain in the background. Now you have a choice to make it fixed where it just sits there, and then you would have to put no repeat, okay? And then that's all you would get, okay? Or you can do it like it was before, where you repeated it and it's not fixed and you just fill it, okay? And so now it just sits there, right? So with Frank Kearns, his is fixed, so it'll scroll, but when you scroll this, yours will be fixed as well. It'll move, okay? Because you have the fill there. And it's gonna fill up as much as it can there, all right? So now, there you go. Now, what would you do next? You know that Frank Kern has white coming up next. So you guessed it. All you would do is come with another section, a whole section. Depends on you how you want to do this. I'm just showing you how to make it. And there is your white section there. Okay. And then I believe he has another one of these. Now, here's what's cool, right? So you could just duplicate this if you wanted to. But this is a different, this one doesn't have the shadow, where this one does have the shadow here. So I'd have to download it, but you get the point, right? So at that point, you just add another section, or we'll just duplicate this section and move it down one. Okay, and then we'll take this one and we'll duplicate it and move it down again. So now you have your sandwich, right? This doesn't look right. Well, I mean, I guess it could look okay because it's got another shadow, right? So that's how you could work that out. All right, and so then at the bottom here, we have another black section for your footer section. Now, again, it just depends on how much. And remember to hit your full width here and then change your background color to black. Okay. And there's the basics of the page right there, folks. Oh, my bad. That was the wrong page. Let's go all the way to the bottom here. Went to the wrong page. That's something else. Okay. Let's do it again. Footer section. Go full width, black, and then boom. So there's the basics of Frank Kern's page. Now, you know, you would have to get his, you know, the pictures and the spiel and put in there, but you're pretty much done with this. This is basic page. Now, what you want to do is make sure that you go in every viewport and look to see how it looks. You know, because in mobile, it's going to look a lot different than what it's going to look like over here. And again, that's what I like this whole thing about. And I do like the preview button where you can go look yourself and see how it's going to look. It looks pretty good. Okay. It looks pretty much how it's supposed to look. It looks pretty much how it's supposed to look. So that's a good deal. So that's the basics of, you know, adding stuff in, folks. Nothing more than that. So we know that Frank Kern had product images over here. Okay. And then he had text. And this is pretty much how you should set up your deal, right? So we know that. And then on this side, normally what people do is we'll duplicate this. Is they'll put the product on this side. And then they will, let's duplicate this one, put the text on that side. And that's pretty much it, folks. That's it. You just keep doing that and finding the images and the text that you need, putting your spiel in, and that's a landing page done. So when you first start your landing pages, this is exactly what you should do. You should look at something you like, see the framework that they use, okay? And bring your sections in first and, you know, understand that when you lay out these sections, when you have to make this choice to say, okay, I wanted four pictures in a row. Usually when you stack that in mobile, those four will, this one will stack on top of this one. Those two will stack on that one. You get it, right? So that's pretty much what you have to keep in mind when you're building these pages is how do you want it to look in mobile? Because, for instance, if you have, if you have all of this text, okay, okay, let's just put this in here. So if you have all of this text in here, like Mr. Kern does, a bunch of spiel, and you don't have, well, that's a lot of shit in it. All right, so, and then you don't have it, this, for mobile, this is what happens, right? So it's going to look really weird. So you're going to have to kind of figure out what you want beforehand and how you want your information to stack up. I like the undo buttons here. They do have that on ClickFunnels as well. But anyway, so you'll have to look at how you're going to stack your information. But for the most part, just kind of draw out what you're going to do beforehand. Look at the page and see how they have things stacked up. Inspect the elements and then lay your page out as well. And always on every move you make, check between mobile and tablet. A lot of times what I do, and if you want a page to look really good, is I totally design the mobile experience separate. I try not to do the same things because this isn't going to look the same at all, right? So I totally try to, and I do, design the mobile aspect. I remove things, I put different things in, and that's what's cool. You just come over here in this advanced tab, and you unclick these items here, right? Or this item. And you just start all brand new with the mobile. And I know you're saying, well, damn, Sonny, that's a lot of work. It is. But in the long run, remember, mobile is what's going to be king here for sure over the next couple of years. So starting to design for mobile is really smart. And guys, that's the basics of building landing pages and landing eye. Coffee break.